Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the previous sessions, we had looked into the strings data type and the various functions, operations, built-in functions which were performed on strings. And today, let's look into the input and output functions available in Python. So friends, at any point of time, if we want to fetch data from the user, so in such cases, the input function comes into picture, and at any point if you want to display output to the user, the output function comes in handy. So how does input function work? So suppose in any programming language, in between the program we want to fetch input from the user at runtime. When the program is running, we want to fetch the data from the input and do some calculations and perform the output. So, in such cases, the input function comes in handy. So, what is the syntax for the input function? The syntax for the input function is input, a display message, and the output would be stored in a variable, say name. Suppose, during your programming, you want to get the name of a particular person. So, in such cases, you can say name equal to input function. So, whenever the Python interpreter encounters the input function, it will display the message which is present in the input function to the console. So, if I say enter the name, enter the name. So, when during the programming, if Python encounters the input function, in the IDLE or any other Python IDEs, the value enter the name would display on the screen. Enter the name will be displayed on the screen, and it requires the user's data at this particular stage. So, if user enters Sam, suppose. So, this Sam will be stored in the variable name. So, name will be having the value equal to Sam. Any data which user enters will be present in the string format. If user enters 123, even this will be stored in the name as 123. So, whatever value user enters, it will be in the string format. So, here input enter the name, and I have entered the name equal to Sam. Now, if I want to see what value is present in the name, I say print name. So, this print is the output function. So, this will display the name on the console, on the monitor. So, print name. Name is having a value Sam. So, Sam would be printed on the screen. This is how input, and input is an input function which enables us to take the data from the user, and print is an output function which displays the data onto the screen. So, this was the example, one of the example for the input function. Now, let's see. Suppose I want to enter the number. Enter the number. So, suppose now I want to enter the number. In such cases, in the console, the date and the display message enter the number would be displayed on the screen. And it waits for the user input. So in this case, if I enter 15 as the number, my name will have the value equal to 15 in the string format. So to perform any mathematical operations, we require it into the integer format. So how to convert this into the integer format? For this, we have to say name equal to, we have to do a type conversion, that is int input enter the name. So once the user has inputted the value, that will be in the string format, and we do int that string format, then the value will be converted into int. That is, type conversion will happen by giving the int function. So now if I say print name, my name will be having the value equal to, the integer value equal to 15. So this is how we can do. Initially it will be in the string format. We can do a type conversion to int, float, or whatever type we want. We can do the type conversion. Now let's see a small program in which we'll take two numbers from the user, perform the addition, and print the output on the screen. So first that we have to take first num1 equal to int. Since it's an integer, we have to typecast with the int input, enter the first number. The first number, and then I say num2 equal to int input, enter the second number. So now in this case, when the program reaches this particular stage, since an input function is there, the cursor goes to the ideally shell where it gives the value, it displays the message, enter the first number, and it waits for the user's input. So suppose if I enter my first number as 15, then the cursor comes to the next line and it asks, enter the second number. So it will display the message, enter the second number, and waits for the user's input. So if user inputs 10, so num1 will have the value 15, num2 will have the value 10. Now we can do the sum, perform the addition on these two numbers, that is num1 plus num2. So it will do 15 plus 10 equal to 25. So sum will be having the value equal to 25 stored in it. But how to display this value to the user? So in that case, we give the output function, which is the print function. So output input is the input function, output is the print function. So we give print double quotes, the sum of braces and braces is dot format, the sum of braces and braces is another braces dot format, then I specify num1 comma num2 comma sum. So when I give the print in this particular format, as we already discussed, in the first braces num1 value would be printed, in the second braces num2 value would be printed, and in the third braces sum value would be printed. So when this particular statement gets executed, the output will be the sum of 15 and 10 is 25. So this is how the value gets printed on the screen. So friends, I hope so it's clear for you. And one more advantage of using the input function is, we need not hard code the value in the program. In the program, if you want to find the sum of two numbers, num1 and num2, if we hard code it, then the program will execute only for those only for a particular set of number. But if we want the flexibility of taking different values, then we have to use the input function so that we can get the values at runtime from the user himself. So in this case, hard coding is also hard coding the values in the program is also excluded, and with the input function we can get the flexibility of taking the data from the user. So this was the input function and the output function. We can see into some more examples of the input and the output function in the lab session. In case you have any doubts, please do reach to me in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.